PH promotes family planning using an integrated population, health and environmental approach. Saving lives through provision of primary health care to people and animals improves community attitudes to conservation. However, high population growth rates reduce shared resources for both people and wildlife.
Well, that's very interesting actually, because in Bwindi, some close colleagues of mine did a study that looked at all the illegal resource use that went on inside the park. And for hunting, there was some kind of suggestions that larger families were more involved in hunting, particularly those that were struggling to find food from other sources. And the other sorts of resource use that happened in the park, for example, pole collecting for construction, which isn't actually permitted inside the park. And there was a very strong link that if you had a larger family, you are much more likely to be someone who would go into the park and collect wood.
The forest where mountain gorillas live is fertile and rich in biodiversity. This has made it one of the most populated regions in Africa, with 85% of the population making its living by growing food on land.
A wildlife health program, plus some conservation work. We also have a community health program, a livestock health program, and we've also started alternative livelihoods so that communities can depend less on the forest and find other ways to depend to be able to survive. We've expanded to also not looking only at gorillas, but also their habitat. And that's why even in the community health program, we're also looking at family planning. When people have too many children, they can't give them proper healthcare, they can't give them an education, and they have to depend on the forest to meet basic needs. So with the family planning program, you find that when you have fewer children, you don't need as much firewood, less likely to go into the forest to hunt because you don't have as much need for meat, alternative protein. You have enough to feed your family with.
The locals are involved in conservation initiatives and do their best to maintain environment livelihood linkages.
Hamwe no kuhinga ni hingaraza mwe nitwe niko turacyeta mu rukiga abantu babyara imiti hamaka gabo mu compound harimo imiti kandi bashuba babyara n'imiti nkahamicika twabona gradiskarema iza ya traininga kumara isandi ibiri yatwegesa uko turatura n'abantu kandi hamwe n'ibikoko kandi uko turerinda ukuhendwa araha bikoko na n'ibikoko kutuyaho burweri kandi hamwe nane ibyokwe barira ruzaro uburunjo burimo.
With a mission to achieve gorilla conservation by enabling humans, wildlife and livestock coexist through improving primary healthcare, Dr. Gladys has recorded tremendous results over the years.
I think the most notable disease, one thing that we're recognizing is, of course we wanted to reduce scabies because it was the first known disease to spread from people to animals, and we have seen a reduction in scabies. We've seen a great increase in people now who have hand washing facilities. It's increased from 10% to 60%. We've seen a great increase in people who are referred to the health centers for tuberculosis, scabies, and things like that. And a disease that we've been looking at too is intestinal parasites in the gorillas. And we've been trying to compare it to what we're seeing in the people and in the livestock. Sometimes we've seen the gorillas have got human parasite in their dung. Most of the time it's not making them sick, but currently we're seeing less and less of that. So we feel that there's much less contamination for the gorillas when they go out to people's gardens. One thing we've also seen is that the gorillas are falling sick much less. We've understood that by improving the community health, the gorillas are picking up less diseases from the community and getting less sick.